Hello children, hi,
good morning.
Today I am sitting here to share us one news to you. What is that? Yes, yesterday I heard one news that is about the coronavirus. You know very well about that virus. Nowadays we are all facing so many problems because of that virus. How do you know about that virus? Maybe you would listen the news in the television or reading in the newspaper. May I write? Yes. What I heard yesterday is, in the past, the ending of the 1918, one influenza came in the world. I will show you some of the pictures. You observe those are all pictures. At those time, one public notice is given to people. That is November 7th, 1918. At that time also, people closed the schools, public places and churches, theaters, picture halls, all are they closed. So like the corona, 100 years back, it visited our world. See this picture, stay at home. Nowadays we are also following the same, the stay at home. This is a picture of they should wear the masks. Nowadays we are all following. Quarantine is also there. Yes, the quarantine is also there. At the time, I have a doubt. What did the people do at those time? Where did they live? How did it spread in those days? What are the symptoms of that disease, that influenza, when it eradicated? That is the story of 100 years back. Let us come to the lesson, what, where, how and when. Now see children, now this is the first lesson of our history part. The lesson name is what, where, how and when. What can we know about the past? Today's news is you learn from the TV or your family members will explain to you. 100 years back's story. Who are ready to explain to you? What can we know about the past? Yes, we can find out about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craft persons, artists, musicians and scientists also. What type of food they ate? Where did they live? How are those members' houses? How did they construct their houses? What games were played by the children? What are the advertisement programs of those people? You answer these are all questions now. In this history, the man's life is divided into three parts: ancient history, medieval history and modern history. In sixth class textbook full you will read the ancient history. If you read the full textbook, at the last you can answer the these are all questions. The farmers, in the those days also farmers are there. Herders, who are keeping the domestic animals, those people are called herders, you know very well. Herders are there. Rulers, kings, ruled our countries. Some of the priests, they have done the prayers for the people. And artisans, businessmen, musicians, scientists, these are all there in the olden days. Next, where did people live? First, now I ask one question to you. Which place you have to choose to live happily on this earth? Three landforms are there. What are those three? Mountain areas, plains and plateaus. Which area you would like to live? As plain areas. What is the reason? In plain areas, all the facilities are available. Water is available. That's why all the people wants to live in the surrounding areas of the rivers. At those days also, people had chosen to live the banks of river. The early people have lived along the banks of the river Narmada for several hundred years ago. Some of the people came from different places and they settled down in our India. First, they settled in the surrounding areas of the Narmada River. Why? The reason is water is available. When the water is available, those areas all are suitable for human beings living. Who are lived in those areas? Skilled gatherers. What is meant by gatherers? Gatherer means gather something, you collect something. That is called the gatherer. Early humans gathered the food items. So those are all called gatherers. Here, skilled gatherer, they have a skill. Which type of animal wealth is available? Which fruits are eatable? Which fruits are the taste? Which fruits are available in their surrounding areas? They knew very well. That's why those members are called skilled gatherers. Skilled gatherers were lived in these areas. They also hunted animals. They did not know anything about our variety types of dishes. They hunted animals. They ate raw flesh. Some of the pictures are there. Here, those people live in dens, in the caves. After that, some of the people, they killed, they hunted one animal, they brought that dead body to that their houses. Okay, children? Now, here I want to show you the India map. It is not clear to you, children. You open your atlas book. What is meant by atlas? It is a book of maps. In atlas book, you open the India physical map. You notice that the Narmada River in it. The Narmada and Tapati, these two rivers flows middle of our India. Okay. Here three mountains are appears to you. Vindhya, Satpura and Ajanta hills are there. Between Narmada and between Vindhya and Satpura, Narmada is flowing. Tapati river flows between the Satpura and Ajanta hills. These two rivers flows through the west direction. Those two connect through the Arabian Sea. Okay, children. Now, here the northwest direction, one river is flowing. Do you know what is the name of that river? Yes, that is Indus River. Indus River, it is based on this river, your India gets its name. Now let us come, how did our country get its name? India, how our India name derived to our country? The two words we use often used for our country are India and Bharat. Some members are called India, some members are calling Bharat. These two are one country names. The word India comes from the Indus River called Sindhu in Sanskrit. In Sanskrit, it has another name that is called Sindhu. Some of the Iranians and Greeks come to our country in the northwest direction about 2500 years ago, the Iranians and Greeks entered in our India. At the time, some members are lived in the banks of the Indus River. Those members familiar with the Indus River and who are living in those areas also. Those people are called Hindus or the Indus. And the land of the east of this river, east of that river, which river here? Indus River, were known as India. Like that, India name derived comes to our country. Another name. What is the another name of our India? Bharat. as. The name Bharat comes the great king Bharata. Bharata, he was one of the greatest king, was ruled our country. It was group of people lived and ruled excellently in our country in the northwest direction. And who are mentioned in Rig Veda about the Bharata, that clan, all the people's history is written in our Rig Veda. Rig Veda, it is one of the ancient Veda. It was written in the Sanskrit language. In the next classes, I will explain you the Vedas. Next, some of the keywords I want to explain here. Traveling. What is the meaning of traveling? Is moving one place to another place. That is called the traveling. Early men were nomads. What is meant by nomads? Nomads means who are moving one place to another place in search of food. Those people are called nomads. Nowadays also we are all moving one place to another place. What are the reasons? Next class, I will explain to you. Manuscript. A book written by hand is called the manuscript. Manu, it is a word derived from the French word main. The meaning of that word is hand. Okay? That is about the manuscript. Inscription. This is writing on relatively hard surfaces such as stone or metal. Some of the kings, they order their orders mentioned in one rock or stone. Those are all called the inscriptions. Archaeology, the study of remains of past. That is called the archaeology. Okay, children, have you understood this? Array, I forgot one thing, that is in our textbook heading. Did you notice the title of the book? Our Pastors. The word pastors in plural. Do you have one plural or so many pastors you have? Yes, we have so many pastors. Why? Because different types of people are living in our nowadays and olden days also living on this earth. For example, the lives of the herders, farmers were different from those kings and queens. It is true even today. In our India, total 120 crore people are living. These are all followed the different types of practices and customs. Everyone has their own past. In this way, our pastor's heading is excellent to our textbook. Have you understood, children? Next lesson, I will continue the remaining part of this lesson. Okay, children, bye.